Ladies and gentlemen, we're here at Northern Impact Wrestling. Today is Sunday, April 15th, and we're here in Amery, Wisconsin for Spring Breakthrough Night 2, the formal edition where everybody wore nice clothes. Hey, this is as nice as they get, smartass. So we're about to get underway our first contest, Darin Corbin and whatever he's calling himself tonight in the pink. And I'm joined here by our lovely camera girl, Sarah, and Angela. This is our first time on commentary. Say hello. Or not at all.
I just said hi.
Oh, well, hello to you as well.
Hello, I guess. Can't really hear what you're saying.
Well, then pay attention. Kleck Michaels with a full arm ringer on Darin Corbin. Corbin with a reversal into a side headlock. We're having technical difficulties. And now we're back. Kleck Michaels with a side headlock takeover on Darin Corbin. What do you think of the action so far, Angela?
Pretty intense.
Pretty intense, huh? Sounds pretty intense. Show a little personality, would you?
Not today. No.
We got a roll up here by Darin Corbin. One, oh, only two.
Am I just talking too quietly? Hello. I should turn it up a bit.
Big shoulder tackle by Darin Corbin. Kleck Michaels finds himself looking at the lights. Leapfrog. Oh, nobody there for Kleck Michaels again. By Darin Corbin, and the girls won't stop talking.
Okay, so am I not loud enough? Oh wait, we're getting the microphone picked up.
Suplex by Darin Corbin on Kleck Michaels. Kleck Michaels is in a world of hurt. Corbin with the crappiest cover I've seen tonight. Let's see some chops, Corbin. Oh, and we get nothing. Whips him from buckle to buckle. Oh, nobody home for Darin Corbin as Kleck Michaels avoids the shoulder tackle. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Nobody home on whatever that was. Corbin whips Michaels off the ropes. Big side leg lariat from Kleck Michaels. And now he's in control. Thoughts on that? Get a shake of the head from Angela. She's disappointed by her man. Kleck Michaels with a reverse chin lock on Darin Corbin. Tonight's commentary is brought to you by Miller Lite. Vicious forearm to the back by Kleck Michaels. Hey, why don't you hand that off to Cruz? You can still stay, but let him do the talking. Thanks, dear. You look good, but you don't sound so great. Left hand by Darin.
All right. And this is Ryan Cruz joining Eric Cannon.
Cruz, you have no idea how great it is to have you on commentary today.
Oh, yeah?
Is it because I'm so cute? Was a waste of space.
Oh, well, you know, that'll happen.
Ooh. Body slam, leg drop combo by Kleck Michaels on Darin Corbin.
It's a very nice combo. Didn't he pull that out on you yesterday? How's that?
Talk about yesterday.
Okay.
More importantly, you're at ringside and Corbin's in the ring.
Yes.
What, you don't have his back?
Well, you know, just come out here and support my buddy. He doesn't need any help. He doesn't need any help.
Fair enough.
Fair enough. But Kleck Michaels in control
with
here.
A handful of hair. Oh, my view's been blocked. There we go. Frost is out of my way.
Oh, back rake a la 1988. Deep from the playbook of one Hulk Hogan. Really working on that back is Kleck Michaels.
Got it.
One, two. Was that a worse cover than the one that Darin did earlier?
No.
Okay.
Corbin with a terrible cover.
Ooh, Darin fire up with that southpaw left.
Fighting back. I'll turn it off. A couple shots to the midsection and one to the face.
He's that southpaw.
Vicious right hand by Michaels. Ooh. The girls at ringside shake their head as they can hear me do commentary. I don't know what the problem is. Corbin in control. You're a girl too. Shut your mouth.
All kinds of bottom buckle on that one to Darin Corbin's schnoz.
Later, why don't you ask him how that tastes?
Okay. I'll ask him at dinner. What's this now? This is not legal. Whoa.
Kleck Michaels obviously doesn't know the rules of professional wrestling.
Referee Rob Page being real lenient with that count. He gave him about 4 9/10 on that.
How's that make you feel? Kleck Michaels more concerned with the girl at ringside than his opponent. That don't bother you at all?
Ooh. It bothers me.
He's a purse stealer.
We'll see about that later tonight.
That's what I like to hear.
Darin
Kleck Michaels on the floor on his knees where he belongs.
Ooh.
Kleck Michaels.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Good for him.
I bet that's not the first time he's been in that position.
Definitely not.
No.
Michael's taking his sweet time getting back into the ring. I think Kleck Michaels needs to stop smoking.
I would agree with that.
I concur.
Bringing him in the hard way. Oh, Kleck Michaels on his feet. Holy shit, we got some House of Fire there. Back senton, 1-2, and a 2-count only, but a far improved cover by Darin Corbin.
I would agree on that.
Very Wayne McCarty in the house, Darin shooting Corbin. Photos all night.
Big belly to back suplex, lateral press.
We got a
1,
and a 2, and a 3, no! Kleck Michaels kicks out at 2, he's not done yet.
Not done yet, that kid's got fire!
Here you go, dear, drink up.
I don't drink.
Get your courage going, let's, come on.
I got water.
Corbin attempting that rock bottom backbreaker. No dice. Back's hurting him.
Yes.
Back. Think the back's hurting from the match or from the backpack duty he's got going on.
I would say probably the match.
Fair enough. Kleck Michaels, CM Punk and twist. No reverse rock bottom backbreaker.
Oh. How's your coattails hanging up?
Doing good today. Doing good.
Cool.
Corbin needs to capitalize on his situation. He's got Kleck Michaels in trouble.
Corbin trying to get some wind in those lungs. Hard to breathe when your back's hurting.
True.
It's almost skiing season, Eric Cannon.
Corbin for the victory roll. Oh, no. Backpack stunner. Oh,
got him with the backpack stunner.
1, 2, 3. There's your winner. The winner of tonight's contest, Darin Corbin.
Darin Corbin with a victory. That's my buddy.
Darin Corbin 1-0 this evening.
Yes. Junk Squad 0-1.
I love to hear that.
Yeah.
I'm going to go out on a limb, and I'm going to call that the best match of the night.
Really?
For now. Yeah.
Who are you wrestling tonight, Eric Cannon?
Some Gus? Yeah. Gus. G-U-S. Greased up skinny.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I cool. like it.
Thoughts?
It should be a good match.
That broadcasting school is really paying off for you. Why don't you?
Referee Rob Page in the house.
Well, you know me and digging up stuff.
Yeah.
The Jump Squad into a bad start tonight. The only thing that would make Rob Page's attire better is if he kept the suspenders on.
I agree. The daytime Urkel look. All right, who's this guy?
Introducing first.
Spiderbaby and I think Ryan Stone.
Oh, boy.
I got nothing.
From Boulder, Colorado, weighing in at 158 pounds, Unbreakable, Ryan.
For those of you listening at home, that's right, he did say the unbreakable Ryan Stone. And I say unbreakable because he's never been in the ring with me.
You would, you'd probably break him.
I definitely could break him.
Maybe next month.
If that's what's in the cards, I'm all for it.
Yeah. I like this song.
They're missing Malikite.
Come on! His opponent from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 171 pounds, Ryan Sachs.
Ryan Sachs versus Ryan Stone.
The Battle of the Ryans. If we had a Cruz in the ring, this would be a true Battle of the Ryans. Oh, my goodness. The guns are loaded at the commentary table tonight, folks.
I believe they're bow and arrows, Mr. Cannon. They are bow and
arrows. Bullet-tipped
arrows, my friend. All right, and this, bathroom break.
The guys in the ring have provoked the entire ringside group to get up and leave. I don't know why, but I don't blame them.
Preview the rest of the match.
All right, Mr. Cruz, pick a winner.
I'm going to go with Ryan.
And Angela, pick a winner.
Ryan also.
I'm not going to pick Ryan. I'm going to go with the guy in the black.
Ooh.
I think we've all made great choices. All Wayne right. McCarty still in the house, shooting lovely photos, but not of this match.
Stone takes the headlock here right away.
No, Ryan takes the headlock.
Ryan
shoots Ryan off. Ryan with a big shoulder tackle on who?
Ryan.
That's right. Good call, Ryan.
Thanks, Arik.
We kind of blew it there.
You could be a Ryan for this match.
Ryan Sachs with a full arm drag.
You're Angela.
It works. Maybe Ryan's like my middle name or something.
There he is.
Angela Ryan. That kind of sucks.
It can be a girl's name.
Big snap suplex by Ryan Sachs. Only a two count.
Now, do you think that's short for saxophone? Anybody?
What's that?
Is it short for saxophone?
Saxophone?
The sexy Kleck Michaels body slam and leg drop combo.
Yep.
Back-to-back matches.
Who'd have thunk?
How do you like that, Cole? You loving it? Cole's a liar. He's full of sarcasm.
Ducks the
full Nelson backbreaker by Ryan Stone.
Didn't quite get the knee out of the way underneath him there to maximize damage.
Him than me, let me tell you.
That's
Darin
true
Corbin.
Story.
Darin Corbin victorious this evening. He's hijacking Angela's commentary.
There are so many Ryans in this match. I just noticed that.
It's funny you mention that. When I asked Ryan who he thought was going to win, he said
Ryan.
And then when I asked Angela who she thought was going to win, guess what she said?
Ryan.
She did. And then when it was my turn, guess who I picked?
Ryan.
No, I picked the guy in the black.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, at least we can tell them apart. I mean, other than the rippling physiques, but.
Spiderbaby again.
You realize if Ryan or Ryan ever watches this DVD, they're going to fucking hate us.
Yeah. Especially the fact that you dropped an F-bomb on commentary.
Fuck, fuckity fuck.
Sweet. Do you know that the tattoo on Ryan's back actually says Ryan in Spanish?
Ryan doesn't have a tattoo on his back.
I'm talking about the other Ryan.
Oh, that one. All right.
I don't have a tattoo on my back.
That's true.
I have a tattoo on my arm.
El Ryan no.
El estúpido.
Ryan just pulled Ryan's hair.
Yeah, I don't like that when that happens.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of that. No, I don't want to sit.
Yeah, we don't want you to sit either. We're fine the way we are.
Yeah.
We will keep our lovely broadcast colleague.
A vicious backbreaker
for the battle
by Ryan
of the Ryans.
Stone. And only a two count.
It's Ryan Stone and Ryan Sachs. The Saxima Stone match.
This match has brought Cole Bauer to his feet, sitting ringside. He can't contain himself. Oh.
Big chop.
Vicious chops by Unbreakable Ryan
Stone. The only thing I can think of when I see chops and Amery is unthinkable. Snapmare, that's a finish.
Oh. Not one, but two indie kicks by Ryan Stone.
Did you call them weenie kicks?
Indie kicks.
Oh, indie kicks. It is a well-known fact that they did originate
in
Indianapolis.
In a cobra clutch of some sort. Oh. Is he tapping out? No, Ryan Sachs is trying to rally the troops.
We're seeing some good Ryan on Ryan action here.
Back to vertical base.
Yes, backdoor vertical base is the name of that submission.
Yeah.
Oh, and the move that Chris V calls the worst exploder ever.
Exploder. I did receive a text from Ryan Stone. One, two, and
actually,
three.
All
no.
Did.
Yes, we all did receive text.
Stone only able
Chris
to get the two counts.
Who is not in attendance tonight?
So we will not. Where is that? Review. Where is that Vetter?
Wild game.
I bet there's no Ryans on the Twins game. Wait.
Another vicious chop from Ryan Stone.
And the side effect version of Ryan Cruz.
Ryan stole Ryan's move.
Ryan just hit Ryan's move.
And only for two. I hope that's not an attempted finish later. Because obviously it doesn't work.
That's true.
Well, maybe he doesn't do it right.
Vicious lyric.
Maybe it won't work on Malikite.
He doesn't have a whole lot of snap.
Followed him up with a back elbow. He's looking for a body slam by Ryan Sachs.
Come on!
He loved that body
Looks
slam.
Like Davey Havoc.
Oh, Trent.
Oh,
Spider.
Shots.
A kick right in Spiderbaby's nose. And this man is snapped.
Do you think he kicked it so hard it's not straight?
It does look a little crooked.
It appears Spiderbaby has just thrown Unbreakable Ryan Stone some sort of an object. I'm not sure what. Oh!
Big
some splendidly brass knuckles.
Wow, that's highly illegal.
Especially in this day and age.
And then rolls him over and...
And we have some more Ryan on
I gotta
Ryan
tell
action.
You, Cruz, it's only legal if you get caught.
True story.
That's just the anarchist in me, but so...
Did you say it's only legal if you get caught?
Oh.
Illegal.
Okay.
It's only a no-no if the ref sees it.
Okay.
Oh.
Wow.
Ryan Stone with the...
Sweet.
The submission victory.
Well, I think I'm gonna go back to the locker room for a little while.
Ryan
Hang out.
Feel free.
Play some PlayStation.
I'll join you.
North Star Express leave the commentary table to battle each other in PlayStation 2's SmackDown vs. Raw. Brought to you by Acclaim. Although official, not an official sponsor of Northern Impact Wrestling. Rob Page helping Ryan back to the back.
Version of this song.
It is good. But the fitting thing about Bobby Brown is that he beats his wife.
Well, hey, then,
let's face it, guys, and girl, every once in a while when he or she gets out of line, that kind of stuff happens.
All too often.
You know,
I couldn't have said it better myself, Angela.
And let's give credit where credit is due.
Let's hear it for Ryan Sachs, Cole. Come on.
Which Ryan?
All right. Oh,
Sachs.
Rob Page doing all the officiating tonight. I wonder where that pretty referee Sarah has gone.
This is a triple threat match for the NIW Impact Championship. Introducing first from the fifth state of Michigan.
Now,
accompanied by Teddy.
I've been wondering this.
He is 6% body fat.
The Punisher's been on a very strict diet and workout routine as of late. And it's quite obvious to anyone watching Northern Impact Wrestling that the Punisher has definitely lost some mass.
Yeah, mass is good.
No, my question is, after having lost so much weight, how does the Punisher still remain 6% body fat?
That's
I was
the
paying
question
attention
of
to
the
two
ages.
Other things.
Oh.
Okay.
The key
Kudos
is-
to you.
That he hasn't lost any mass in his behind.
His ass.
Oh.
He's got plenty of ass mass.
So all the mass is in his ass.
Uh-oh, this sounds like Hindu.
It's actually...
What kind of Armenian crap is this?
I think
ask
he's
Tyler
from
Black.
Iran, maybe?
Tyler Black
music?
Is Armenian. Let's get that on NIW commentary.
It actually sounds like Lita's entrance music to me.
We don't talk about
all
Lita.
All I hear is...
That girl's a whore.
All I'm hearing is Dirk a Dirk.
Hey, now.
Made.
From Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Rocking the purple tonight.
Ariya Daivari.
Ariya Daivari in the house. Not the only Daivari, but definitely Angela's favorite. Making his
true.
Making his debut here in Amery, Wisconsin.
I remember that last night.
For Northern Impact Wrestling.
And it's well-known fact that Ariya Daivari used to work at a flooring store. That's why he carries carpet with him everywhere he goes.
The thing about looking like Daivari and having the nose like he does, you got to bring your own rug places because that's the only munching he's going to get done.
That's true.
Oh, come on.
He might hit the carpet muncher tonight. Or Rob James might be hitting. Hey, that's a hate crime right there, Eric Cannon.
Whoa, hey now.
Hey!
Hi-oh!
Ariya Daivari sporting some very purple attire this evening.
What now?
Yes, what now? The profit is what's now.
Oh. About half a beer later, Angela's finally getting some one-liners in.
After, weighing in at 169 pounds, he is the NIW Impact Champion, the Prophet!
I believe the Prophet is the longest reigning Northern Impact Wrestling Impact Champion in the history.
And it also is one of the longest reigning champions in Minnesota at the moment.
Wow. How do you know all these facts?
I'm just good like that. When you watch one too many Ryan on Ryan matches, you get to know your way around the business quite a bit.
Understood.
What?
Understood. I concur.
That statement has made me totally discombobulated.
No, that's not a word.
Discombobulated
is
a word.
It's a five-syllable word.
I don't. I'll have to disagree with that.
How would you like to make a little wager?
Okay.
We'll talk backstage, or at least when the mics are off.
Oh, okay. I bet the viewers out there are wondering, what could this be?
Everyone at home watching, grab your dictionaries and look up the word discombobulated. You'll see that the Air Cannon is not only a great wrestler, but he's got quite the vocabulary as well, unlike our dear friend Angela here, making her debut on commentary. Even as a college student, she doesn't have the greatest vocabulary.
4 years of college education has gotten me nowhere.
At least you got to go to Egypt.
That's true.
True.
Did you bang any pharaohs?
I didn't. Well, they're all dead, so that would be necrophilia, my friend.
Yeah, but, well, yeah, good point.
That was there's a big no, word I just
said. Back to the action.
Oh. All right, this is a three-way.
Thoughts on three-ways there, dear?
You know it. You dreamed about it.
I think it's
good
for the title. I think.
Depending on who's in the three-way.
Fantastic, fantastic. And for this particular three-way, we've got Northern Impact Champion, Impact Champion, the Prophet, taking on 6% body fat all in his ass, Rob James. And the debuting here in Amery, Wisconsin, Ariya Daivari.
If I'm gonna go against two guys,
or Ariya Daivari, as I like to say. It flows off the tongue much easier.
The girls at ringside, not only checking out the Punisher's ass, but taking photos as well. Everyone's a fan, everyone's a fan.
You know you liked it. You know you liked it. You liked it. Whoa, ref. Come on.
They just turned around and nodded. They indeed liked
There's
it.
There's a lot of minorities here.
True, we have
Daivari taking the opening given.
The Punisher is black.
Oh, what do we have here?
Well, he has to have some.
He's got a Badunkadunk.
We've got a 2-on-1 here. It appears Daivari and Rob James are in.
Forming an alliance.
Ooh, alliance. Great word.
Oh, forearm. Punch.
Oh, they're going to throw him off. I heard it. Punisher said
so. To the opposite side.
By the Prophet.
Keep the Prophet down.
Double Naga Naga! A little formal introduction there by the Prophet.
Oh.
In and out goes Daivari.
Button party balls. High inverted Atomic Manhattan drop. And beautiful front face bulldog.
Shades of the giant Baba.
Yes, who is also dead, God rest his soul. Fist drop. Shades of Ted DiBiase.
God bless the fist drop.
Yeah, God bless.
God bless Ted DiBiase.
I love fisting.
Literally, he's a God-fearing
You know, Angela. Everyone has a price.
For the million-dollar man. Just that sweet sapphire.
I learned that at a very young age.
Sweet sapphire. Getting funky like a monkey.
She took the price off.
Daivari clobbering the Prophet in the back.
You get me like that. You
would have
done the same thing. But now she's dead, and we don't care.
Who are we talking about?
Sweet sapphire. Come on.
The Prophet in a bad way as both Daivari and the Punisher, Rob James, taking turns.
It's a smart game plan, Eric Cannon, and a coalition here. 2-on-1 is better odds than 1-on-1-on-1.
That's true.
It's hard to beat two opponents, hard enough as is, but to beat two opponents working together, the profit...
Let's face it, for somebody like Rob James, it's hard enough to beat one opponent.
Yeah. Stomps to the thigh. I don't know, let's ask him. Picking on longtime fan, Sandy.
Vicious body slam by Daivari on the Prophet. They're just stalking their prey, our Daivari and the Punisher.
Simultaneous picking apart of the Prophet.
Oh. Punisher with the asshole chop.
Asshole. Not to the asshole.
Put a foot up, Prophet. Come on. Oh. He's still the champ right now.
That's a good point.
That's right. I know the rules. I know the rules.
You must pin the champion or make him submit to win.
Actually, I believe in this match.
Oh.
Whoever gets pinned, or whoever does the pinning, rather, will be our new Impact champion.
One fall to the finish, huh? So the Prophet doesn't even have to get pinned.
The Prophet's, you know, pretty much screwed in this match.
The odds are against the champion. This does not look good for the Prophet.
Whoa! Come on, Prophet! Come on,
Prophet in a bad way here. There we go.
Fighting back.
Prophet, a house of fire, shades of sting.
Good one.
You like that?
I like that one.
Wow.
Hey,
you know,
I've been around a while. I've been around
a
while.
Is, right? TNA superstar?
Of course. Well,
maybe he'll be in the
Impact
invitation.
Think of him as a WCW superstar.
That's true.
He will.
What?
He'll be at the invitation?
No, he might.
Oh.
I really hope that.
Look at the back elbow by the Prophet. Cover 1-2 and no.
Oh, we almost had the same champion.
Fantastic play-by-play by Darin Corbin.
Ah, yes. You should check out my IWA stuff. That's crap.
IWA?
Yeah.
Oh. I thought you meant the commentary.
Yeah, my commentary.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Oh, the commentary we do. Prophet fighting back.
Oh, and
it just doesn't seem he can mount any offense. As soon as he starts in on one guy, another guy from behind.
Oh, double dropkick with authority. That knocked the wind out of him.
Prophet appears to be throwing a hissy fit in the ring.
And a move that has been used by many Middle Eastern men around the world.
The eye rake? That was an eye rake.
Oh, it was an eye rake.
Yeah.
Well, that's been used too.
I'm sure it
has. Your vantage point kind of sucks.
They like to call it the sandstorm over there.
I've been in a sandstorm.
Because they're in the desert?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
What did you think I was talking about?
Low blow by the prof on the Prophet?
Yeah. Going down south.
Speaking of, forget it. Forget it.
All right. TVMA.
Yes, are we putting a rating on this DVD?
Whenever Eric Cannon and Darin Corbin get together, it's not a good idea for comedy to have ratings. We just go unscripted.
I bet it'll be a long time before we see this show on DVD.
You mean you're not going to buy it?
No, I mean, I don't think it'll be available anytime soon.
Yeah.
Well, that'll just increase the value.
All the fans.
The Prophet.
Oh,
nice.
Oh, my God.
Two.
Oh! He almost got a brown
A face
star.
Full of scrotum on Daivari there. Nobody likes that, or
the
do they?
Teabag.
No comment. Once again.
And check Arya's eye for a brown mark.
Oh,
he's kind of already brown.
He's got him stacked in the corner.
Oh, I think I see what's coming here.
You do?
Oh.
Nice.
Fantastic.
Uh-oh.
A spectacular move by Daivari there to avoid the Punisher.
If you're seeing the look I'm seeing from this point of view, it ain't pretty.
Punisher hung out to dry, literally.
The only thing holding up.
Oh. Nobody likes to be on the receiving end of that.
And I was pretty convinced that would be over.
So was my mom.
Yeah. she drinking?
I hope not.
All right.
I'll buy her a drink.
We don't joke about things like that. I think this might be all downhill ever since Punisher took a shot to the ass. Wait, that came out totally wrong.
He's still the champ. He's still the champ.
Don't tell me I know that. I'm on commentary.
We have to know those things.
She's got a comeback. That was a good one.
Did Daivari just rattle off something in Arabic?
That's a language?
Actually, he speaks Farsi.
And you speak?
Farsi?
Arabic.
Oh.
Is that like that Igpe Atenle or whatever that is?
Sure.
Akfe Uye.
Ooh, Farsi. Farsi.
So are there any differences that you can explain to us between Farsi and Arabic?
Well,
or no?
It would be very complicated and it would take away from the match.
When you went to Egypt, did you ever see action like this inside
a
wrestling?
No, there was no wrestling in Egypt.
Double knees.
No wrestling in Egypt. Just goes to show you that if we were to run
and the Punisher spills to the floor,
it would draw.
It would draw.
Daivari.
There it is.
Prophet mounting a comeback.
Fire.
Whip reversal by Daivari into an airplane. No.
Another reverse.
Here it comes.
Is it?
A falcon arrow of sorts.
Sort of.
As my voice cracks,
yeah.
Like when I was 13.
One, two. Oh, near fall, and we almost had the same champion yet again.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, you are.
Yeah.
You're a slow drinker, but.
Well, so are you.
I'm doing all the talking.
I hope they can't hear us drinking on the mic.
Uh-oh.
It'll be fine.
It's over.
It's the old shit driver.
If he wouldn't have taken time to predict that it was over.
And do we have
the message? No.
I thought it was going to be a different version of the message. Uh-oh. Oh.
It's over.
Not looking
Shades
good
of
for
Chris
the
Chetty right there with the Amityville,
Amityville horror.
Horror.
Fantastic reference.
Yes, that's very good.
And
watch the fan
on the rug.
Oh! Punisher, empty pool.
Oh.
Knees up on the magic carpet ride.
Oh, and he just ate carpet.
Literally.
Yes.
Oh,
unbelievable. Oh.
One, two, three.
And the message is. The message is. Prophet is still the champion.
The Prophet retains the Impact title in what was the most lopsided three-way dance I have ever seen.
That was a two.
But you got hands to the Prophet for pulling out such great fortitude in this match.
Fortitude. The magnitude of his effort in this match, indescribable.
The Prophet overcomes the odds here tonight in Amery.
Once again.
At the TAC as he retains the Northern Impact Wrestling Impact Championship.
Now, what does the TAC stand for?
The what?
The TAC.
I have no clue.
You can't just make something up.
And that rain continues.
No.
What is it now, like?
Long time.
14 months?
That's over a year.
Over a year.
Yeah. Wait, wait, wait. Yeah, it's like 17 months, actually.
It's over a year. 385 days, over a year.
Let me just put it this way. A Prophet, he's got longevity.
Long hair, too.
Yeah.
Yep.
Not making any friends tonight.
Ariya Daivari runs up the rug and heads home.
Don't forget Teddy Punisher, Rob James.
It's hard to call him Rob James when I've called him the Punisher for so many years. You know what the funny thing is? It's still easy to call him an asshole.
Yeah. Shut up. He just told that girl in the front.
6% ass fat, loses the match tonight, and heads to the back.
You people saw him cheat. You saw him cheat.
The Punisher never ceases to amaze me with his constant pissing and moaning. Take your boyfriend and hit the showers, punk.
There we go.
How does that taste?
Y'all well, set? I'm all set.
With your...
Because now I'm with a very beautiful co-commentary.
Why, thank
lady.
You. Lady. I guess I can be called a lady. I am getting pretty old.
I mean that in the finest and delicate of most compliments.
Why, thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Hang on a second. I'm going to switch microphones. Here comes my tag partner, Ryan Cruz. I'm eating french fries. I'm happy as a clam. My voice is cracked.
Yes, it did. I think it's something about that chair.
His opponent from Shea Stadium weighed in at 179 pounds.
Woo!
Ryan Cruz!
And the fans are on their...
And that's right. French fries are making my voice crack.
Don't choke on those. You could sue this place, you know.
That's true. I love the french fries, though. All right. And it was supposed to be Trent Jones and Ryan Cruz tonight. However,
I spent too much time in the sun.
Trent Jones was in a severe car accident and broke his back, so he will not be here tonight, but he should be here in a week.
We all send our thoughts to Trent Jones and family.
Well, his family's also dead, too. Well, anyway.
Let's go on with the match. Robert.
Customary bell with the wrench on it.
Did you just say wench?
Yeah, no, I said wrench. I think I'm coming down to something. Maybe tuberculosis.
Oh, wow. Where'd you get that from?
I don't know. I think it's a kissing disease, actually.
I thought that disease was dead.
Vaccinated, but you know.
Oh, third world countries, actually.
Oh, that's
TV
right.
All around.
Speaking of third world countries, you're from Egypt, right? Or no, you went to Egypt, that's right.
I went there for a week and a half. That does not qualify me as being from there.
Oh, well. I forgive you.
In my heart. You're from Ireland, right?
What?
And you're from Ireland.
What gives you that idea?
Just the
hair?
Yeah. Just a little bit.
No, I'm actually not from Ireland. I don't have any Irish in me, actually.
Oh, wow.
And he just bit Malikite, thinking that he was a giant Easter bunny.
A giant what?
Easter bunny.
Oh, wow.
Cause Malikite.
Hollow in the scepter.
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Racist remarks being thrown on.
These
all
aren't
around.
Racist. I'm proud of the fact that Malikite's black. Pinky swear.
Wow.
All right, you can't break that. Hey, what? I'm on. Come on.
Faked him out there.
Oh, he just lured him in with that one. And a hammerlock into a go-behind, into a snapmare. Roll through. Bipasso, drop down. Arm drag. Malikite feeds up, and arm drag down again. Tommy the Spiderbaby Saturday on the outside with his protege, Malikite, and a kick to the extremities.
The extremities.
Yeah, isn't that like your gut and everything?
The extremities is your arms and your legs.
Wow.
Close, though.
Wow.
Close.
Another arm drag. Driving Malikite hard to the mat. Hip toss.
Beautiful.
Spin kick.
Malikite is
not doing
and Malikite powers. What was that?
He's not doing very well.
No, no, no. Ryan Cruz is way better than Malikite. It's a well-known fact.
Well,
you have to agree with me on this.
I agree.
Yeah.
Not just because he's your tag partner, but because his moves far surpassed Malikite.
That's true. Uh-oh. And we have a convention going on. The kick to the gut. Maybe he's going to suplex him on the floor. Oh, he's already in the ring, so I guess that doesn't make any sense. Oh! Spiderbaby. There it is.
Here we go!
He's going for a DDT. Shucks him off. Here it comes. Uh-oh.
Wow, fancy moves right there.
Wow! Malikite twirled around him.
That was a nice reversal.
Satellite Russian leg sweep.
Oh. Even fancier name.
I know.
Darin Corbin, how you doing?
I'm doing just fine. I sold a DVD. I have a lovely commentator to my left.
Excellent.
I'm doing just fine. And I just got her all sweaty.
Well, I'm glad that you talked about me like that. So I am a very lovely man. So.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Hey, that.
Uh-oh.
And he has his suspenders on. We've got to.
So what?
That is true.
Makes everything.
He's bringing sexy back.
Definitely.
I don't understand what Malikite's trying to do. Is he trying to tuck in a shirt?
Malikite isn't wearing a shirt.
No, tuck in Rob Page. Rob Page's shirt.
Sometimes Malikite has very unorthodox ring methods.
You know, that's what suspenders are for.
That's true, to hold up the shirt.
Well, not only the suspenders, but he also has a belt on as well.
Exactly.
By golly, you're right.
So he's
not using the brain tonight.
If double those pants fall down, it will be the intervention of God that makes
yes.
it fall. What a lariat!
Ooh.
Shades of Stan Hansen right there with that lariat. Oh, and a stomp.
A stomp to the extremities, right?
The extremities, yes.
The lower intestine.
Lower intestine.
Those central extremities.
Central extremities, yes.
Okay.
And if people are inbred, sometimes they do have arms growing out of their stomach, so the term works.
I haven't seen that happen too often, but I'm sure it does.
Only in Wisconsin, my friend.
Only in Wisconsin.
Yep.
Amery, to be exact.
Yeah, there's a lot of weird stuff that's happened in Amery before.
Let's not talk about that.
No, we won't talk about that. But I'd like to give a shout out to our good buddy Glenn, who is not with us tonight, but good friend of everyone at NIW. And
we wouldn't be here without Glenn.
That's true. A good friend, a good man. Oh, and a rake to the eye.
40 hits, you know?
Oh, I loved it.
Gave us the pull.
Oh, a hair whip right there. Speaking of pull, he pulled him down by his hair.
See,
I'm witty like that. I pulled a Michael Cole on commentary. Sit down in front. It's actually quite funny. I can, if I lean back far enough, I can watch the match from here and on hard cam.
There's some special.
Oh, a
talents.
Kick into the face. He went for that lariat. What's this gonna be? Oh, there's that SEMA pin. That would have been a three count. But there's a spider baby on the apron.
A spider baby.
A spider baby. The one, the only spider baby. If you know anyone else. Oh!
Oh. Big
boom. Oh my gosh. Ryan Cruz with the kick out after a hard kick to the face that would make Jean-Claude Van Damme blush. God, I'm losing my voice. Well, you know what, Malikite? If you're not going to get the pin there, you're probably not going to get the pin any other time.
I'm sure he was trying to just catch him off guard.
I'm sure. But the only way he'd catch him off guard if there was no lights on in the building, if you catch
right.
my drift. Shoot reverse again. Oh, he blocked it. He missed a leg drop. Luckily, Malikite turned around a little slow.
Taking advantage of the situation.
He's taking advantage of it.
I didn't say.
But he's still working at a very slow pace, though.
That's the methodicalness of Malikite.
Ah.
He has a method.
Oh! And Malikite is out! Like,
Dave Chappelle is out of the country.
Yeah, that was that one wasn't very good.
He came back, so that.
In what sense? Good taste or metaphor?
I didn't think it was very effective.
Oh, no, no. But the kick was effective, however. Segway, Michael Cole style. Anybody want my pickle? I know that sounds weird on commentary.
I hope that the listeners know there's a pickle sitting in front of you that's not your own.
There is. But both men are to their feet. Punch!
That
blocks
the Malikite.
That's a
nice looking pickle you got there.
Thank you, Frosty. If you want, you can take a bite of it.
Could I?
But these guys are going back and forth. Oh, big back elbow. He's up. Heart attack, clothesline. Shades of Bret Hart. I won't put my arm back. Body slam. Shinoku driver. Near fall. I thought that was it. No! Don't go up. Watch out. There, see, that's why.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Spider's trying to get him in his web of deceit. His web of cheating. His web of lies.
Oh, that was good.
We did that. We were thinking on the same page.
And looking at it.
Leg drop. Oh. That had to hurt Ryan Cruz. That dang Spiderbaby interfering.
Why is he even
Oh!
You need to be at ringside help, not your buddy.
I'm doing commentary. Oh! Near fall! I don't need to be at ringside. Because I trust my friend Ryan Cruz.
He's got it under control.
Come on, Ryan! Big powerful shoot reverse. Duck go behind. O'Connor roll. Hang on. Here comes Mally. Wheelbarrow. Oh, way.
Hey.
Oh, come on.
How does that work?
Come on. No one wants to see Malikite win. Spider Baby. That was cheap. Whatever Spider Baby did, it was cheap.
And he carries him out like a sack of potatoes.
That's your everybody.
All this stuff about me, why don't they just let me live? What?
Yeah, I don't know where that's
Maybe that's
from.
The pickle.
Oh, you might need to put your arms down. Then.
Oh.
Yeah.
I am pissed as hell. I'm going to just say that. That was, you saw that, Frosty. Unfortunately, referee Rob Page didn't see it.
Yep. I can't do anything about it. Referee Rob Page, he's the man that's in charge while the rings are, while the match is going.
It's the suspenders.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
Nobody wants to see Ryan Cruz lose to Malikite.
No one wants to see Ryan Cruz lose, period.
Exactly.
He's a crowd favorite and favorite here at Amery, Wisconsin.
Tears rolling down their cheeks right now.
I think the crowd is literally
and beer going down their throats. The more beer you drink, the funner the shows are. Just remember that.
Introducing first, from Iowa City, Iowa, weighing 168 pounds,
I'm in this crappy
town. The future, Joey Envy!
Joey Envy is pointing to the ceiling. He has no respect.
There are children present.
I thought he was pointing to the ceiling. I didn't know if he was trying to say something to the fans.
What a jerk. I hope Joey Envy gets his ass kicked. Yes.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Oh! I changed to make everyone stay the same. I'm gone so long. Thank God, cause I'm better off on my own. In 3, 2, 1.
And his opponent from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 200.
Who's going to ring the bell if Frosty isn't here?
Not me.
Yeah, exactly.
I hate ringing this stupid thing. I'm doing double duty tonight.
I don't know when to ring it.
When the ref tells me to. Check it. Ah, doing double duty. Commentary.
I need to learn how to ring the bell. My next goal.
Your next goal?
After I conquer commentary, bell ringing.
You're doing a good job. You make my experience very, very delightful out here.
I could just leave you by yourself.
No, 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 no. I want you to keep me company. Fair enough. You know what I'm saying.
If I could purr, I would purr back at you.
All right. Tight arm ringer here by Eric Cannon into a headlock by Joey. These two are no strangers to each other. They've had battles over the NPW Universal Championship. They have also been in TLC matches against one another. And now here in NIW, they are going one-on-one in Amery, Wisconsin, which I believe is the first time that Eric Cannon and Joey Envy have wrestled in this building.
I believe it is.
But what a strong legacy.
Well, Joey Envy is a relatively newcomer when it comes to wrestling at NIW in Amery, Wisconsin.
That is true. That's true.
So,
Joey Envy, though, however, has been around the Minnesota area for quite a while.
Oh, definitely.
Has racked up quite an impressive resume of titles and opponents.
Right.
He did beat AJ Styles, technically, in a four-way for the Universal Championship at MPW. And he was the last MPW Universal Champion.
Yes, he was.
He'll also be at first.
He did not pin AJ Styles.
No, of course not.
We just want to make that clear. But
there's no way Joey Envy could pin him. He was like half his size at the time.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, you know, let's give credit where credit's due. Oh, beautiful. And he's got him in the top wrist lock.
But a win is a win.
A win is a win. A title's a title. He did lose it to Jimmy Jacobs at an IWA show in a three-way, also involving Josh Abercrombie on March 11th, 2005.
Right.
But won it back shortly after on the Saturday show and got it back at MPW. Not just a hat rack, my friend. I know my history. Many people think I'm all about joking around and saying inappropriate things, but I actually know how to be professional when it comes around.
You just like to do that on your spare time.
I do that on my spare time. I'm a legend in my spare time, which is also a Bloodhound Gang song as well.
It is.
Good man.
I know you know what I'm talking about. That's both Angela and I, a secret, guilty pleasure, I would say, right?
Oh, I'm a
Gang?
Yeah.
I'm a
Yummy Down on This?
Yes, Yummy Down on This. I've dreamed of a girl to say that to me, whatever context it is.
There you go.
Well, I can die a happy man now.
Yeah, I'm a very very long-standing Bloodhound Gang myself.
I like it.
Myself, so.
Shot to the gut. Shot to the gut. Sends Joey Envy off. Drop down. Best title drink in the business right there. Shades of Bruiser Brody right here.
I'm surprised Cannon's able to stand after all that.
That was wonderful.
Making himself dizzy himself.
Oh
man, I can't talk myself.
Dude.
Self.
We are, my throat's going.
We're gone.
Yeah.
We're not nearly as witty as we were the last time.
No, we were pretty witty last night.
That's okay.
We had to. Remember we had the innuendo joke off?
Yes.
That didn't go so well. Not, I think I raised the bar for
long,
us.
But yes.
Oh, no!
You'll never find out. Shut up, old man. Two.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
the crowd reaction from
got him right there.
Yeah. She's a great fan, you know?
Great.
It's a great breakfast.
We need more like her.
True. We need more people that show up.
If we could have 50 or 70 more people just like her.
The whole town of Amory, Wisconsin, I think we'd be set.
Yeah.
Yeah! Quit fidgeting.
Oh! Still hit it.
And who's the spam put
participation is dead. It's alive and well here at Amery, Wisconsin. I don't know. But if anyone said it, I proved them wrong.
That's one of those nice made-up facts of Darin Corbin. Yeah.
The best facts are the ones that are made up. Am I right?
Right.
And just for a little side note, I have $16 in my pants.
Excellent.
Those are some pretty tight pants.
Thanks for noticing. If you find the dollar, you can have it, Angela, but until then.
Well, someone else.
I maybe should have announced that.
After the $16.
It seems like a lot of people are after my money.
You want a pickle? You want his pickle.
Anybody want a pickle? Yeah, go ahead.
The offer's on the table.
The offer and the pickle is gone. But I can't tell you who it went to. Just say a lucky fan. A lucky supporter of... NIW. And Joey Envy is in control. I think it pissed him off that he got chopped by a fan. Me?
Beautiful, folks.
I already ate all my fries. Or is he even talking to me?
Joey Envy is hungry.
All he's doing is just doing commentary. He's just jealous because he's not getting any fries.
Right.
Joey should eat something, though. He's like 130 pounds.
I think he saw someone eating your pickle, and I think that's what he was jealous about.
Yeah, well, everyone gets jealous when they, you know,
when they can't eat your pickle.
Yeah, when they can't get at my pickle.
Right.
I normally keep it well hidden. But the offers are on the table.
Gone now.
Oh, yes. And again, I can't say who took the pickle, but we can say that Joey Envy is in control of this match, segue number 3.
How the tables have turned.
Oh, how this match. Oh, he's got him in a headlock. I don't think that's going to work.
We all know that they love Eric Cannon. This is.
No one wants to chop Eric Cannon because if they chop Eric Cannon, he will probably hit him back. Eric Cannon has gone on record by saying that he wants the Yakuza 3-year-old. But in my defense, that kid was hideous.
You saw the kid?
Oh, no!
These giant hands.
Oh, my God!
Oh, my.
That was awesome.
Andre the Giant just chopped it.
That was a big, nasty Mad Lions-esque chop right there. In the life and power.
Oh, my gosh.
That oh, my God.
Biggest chop that NIW has ever seen.
What's going to happen next? Let's just have fans put arm ringers on, guys. Why not?
Oh. I think we're going to have Joey E versus that guy the next NIW show in Amery.
That's what we should do.
Fans
pick the wrestler matches.
Yes.
And he's got Joey. It's like an episode of Sesame Street at Amery.
Joey Envy is... just screaming in pain now. I think Eric Cannon's going for a full minute. Maybe not.
And that would make the blood rush to your head.
I would think so.
It would be really strong to do that. Because with the combination of gravity plus body weight, even right. A man like Joey Envy can feel like the weight of the iron chop Joey Envy.
I think Rob.
I think this might be a precursor to a 10 punch in the corner. or a job maker, whatever. Bob Backlund's a good man. Used to have dinner with the guy. We ate fish because it was Lent.
What?
Whatever. My buddy Ryan Cruz out here. Just so you know, Both Spiderbaby and Malikite cheated to beat you. But we sold a DVD, so it's all good.
Sweet, that's going to buy me dinner.
Yeah, it will.
Two dinners, actually.
Yeah, well, ooh, hey. All right. Joey Envy back in control again after some friendly banter between Rob Page and Eric Cannon. Snapmare into a chin lock. He's got that knee driven into the latissimus dorsi or the extremities of the back.
Exactly. Extremities of the shoulder blades.
Shoulder blades, yes. But this crowd, this capacity crowd rallying behind one Joey Envy. Shot to the gut. Oh! Oh! There it is, the neckbreaker. Oh! You can see that one on Wrestling Society X. MTV Trios. Oh, I thought it was Trace.
Oh, I thought it was Trios.
Hey, either way, it's Spanish or yeah. Something
it's
weird.
No ESPN 8, the Ocho.
That's true. That has dodgeball on it. That's right, Cotton. All right. Purple Cobras. Huh? And he punches him down. There it is.
There you go.
Bunches of punches.
Bunches of punches.
Sounds like a Dr. Seuss thing in the commentary.
Oodles and noodles.
Oodles and noodles and... Oodles and noodles and puddles of poodles.
Ah.
Has nothing to do with this match whatsoever.
But what does?
Yeah. You got Darin Corbin on commentary. And if you want, if you like this match, if you like Eric Cannon being in complete control of Joey Envy, you can also go to www.myspace.com/NorthStarExpress and buy our DVD. shameless plug.
What does that have to do with Eric Cannon and Joey Envy?
Let me give you the rundown. Joey Envy versus Eric Cannon. Both trained at MPW. North Express DVD available. Buy it. Support us.
That sounds really logical.
Oh, look at this. Look at this hole. The standing walnut tree submission. Brought to you from Japan. As Satoshi Kojima over... I think I pronounced that wrong. Either way, he's got the arm behind him.
Painful, that's all I have to
that
say.
Looks like
stretch,
very painful.
It does stretch your extremities.
His shoulder extremity is sticking out in a way I've never seen before.
More than the central extremity.
Oh, he's got to break this hold.
He's got awfully. Five counts, so.
And Rob Page.
Rob Page proving he can count to four.
Yes. Joey Envy with quick wit using the guillotine, which can be seen on all THQ video games. You can give them to your created wrestlers.
I think you
THQ is not a sponsor.
Not of us.
We've had
but you just wait until the classic NIW video game comes out and you can play as Eric Cannon and Joey Envy. And by the NIW video game, I mean if you buy No Mercy and create the wrestlers on the game.
Right.
You can also do it on SmackDown versus Raw, too, whichever one you want.
Create a wrestler.
Blistering chop. Blistering chop right there. No one throws chops harder than Joey Envy, except Eric Cannon.
I was going to say, bold statement.
Yeah. And I just got the look of death from the female at the commentary.
The female.
And that's devastating. Version of the abdominal stretch.
Rob James, I always thought they had a pretty good chop, though.
Yeah, they hurt.
Yes. I wouldn't know, so that's why I was
asking. Well, I lost a couple nipples in my day.
Ah. It's a good thing they grow back.
Exactly. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Big punch.
Completely took Joey Ever off guard.
Right in a row, as we call that in the business, a trifecta. Explode! Barry shades out Kenta Kobashi with the exploder.
Oh, shit. Come on, Rob.
Did he just curse?
I think he said shoot.
Oh, shoot.
Yes.
Stop or my mom will shoot. Stop or my mom will shoot.
Yes.
Starring Estelle Getty.
Yes.
Never seen that movie.
With Sylvester Stallone, yes.
How did she give birth to that? So that's one of the timeless questions ever. How did Estelle Getty pass Sylvester Stallone through her birth canal? There's a 10 punch I'm talking about!
Exactly.
There's a lot of counting in this match. We've seen counts to 3, we've seen counts to 5, we've seen a 40-second hanging submission. You multiply them all together, you get 2,400. Joe Envy to the top, quick as a cat. Watch out.
Oh, missile drop.
Missile drop kick. Or else the Japanese called it in World War II, the Black Death.
Another completely wrong fact by Darin Corbin.
Hey. All right.
If nobody can prove you wrong, then it's right.
Exactly. The best kind of facts are the ones that are made up. Under. Hang him on the rope to dry. Snap. Like a fish. Like a limp fish. He might be calling for the warlock. A move that he's put out. All right, here it comes. He's stalking him. He's put out. Soundtrack.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Do you want me to keep staying?
As a long pose.
He runs from the curtain.
This contest is for the NIW Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challenger. Weighing in at a total flyweight of 507 pounds. Well,
Bret O'Brien seemed to have a little bit of trouble getting in the ring. I think he started drinking early.
Yeah, well, that's what they do.
Yeah.
And speaking of drinking, I hate the Junk Squad.
Well, not many people really do like them.
I don't know.
They're not on my Christmas card list. I'm not going to say that. And I have a lot of relatives that I send Christmas cards to that I don't like either. None at all.
What? And it's not the Junk Squad.
Pete Hughes needs to not quit his day job.
I give you voice lessons.
I don't.
Pete Hughes shouldn't quit his day job because singing, and he's not that attractive.
Right.
So either way, it's kind of a lose-lose. Don't blow kisses at me. It's creepy. Oh, Sarah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I suppose.
You blame him.
No, Sarah's pretty hot.
I think it was you that they were blowing kisses at.
Either way.
I don't know.
Angela's popular with the wrestlers.
Oh, thank you. My belt.
No comment. For like the fifth time tonight.
It's okay. There's no need to hide it here. We're all friends. It just stays between us. No one else will hear this.
Not
right, exactly.
All. Us three. We aren't even on.
Yep. The three of us. Rotisserie. Sorry. Anyway, back to the match.
Chicken, I'm pretty hungry right now.
Oh, I am.
You should have taken advantage of eating my pickle.
I should have.
You would have felt so much better. Yeah, you would have felt so much better if you had stuck your my pickle in your mouth. It would have made you feel good because as it went down your throat, down into your stomach.
I was contemplating eating your pickle, but I noticed it wasn't big enough. So.
Oh.
You have standards.
Exactly. The kind of hunger that I have demands a much bigger pickle.
Ooh.
The crowd is a little potty mouth today.
We got a little potty talk going on in Amery.
And those tag team belts are on the line.
I hope that they lose those tag belts because I hate they. I just don't like these guys.
No.
I have such a distaste for them that I can't even think straight when they're in the ring. Nobody wants to see that. One in, one out, Junk Squad. Just like the...
Rock, paper, scissors.
Just like the orgies that they have in their...
Paper covers rock. You know, in rock, paper, scissors tournaments, most of the time males have rock as their very first hand.
Is that a true fact? Or?
Yeah, I'm kind of a rock, paper, scissors connoisseur.
Wow. And what do girls do then?
They do either or. They do one or the other. They're very hard to tell, but men, for some reason, they want to always do the rock for the first one.
I faded out. It's a sunny day.
You did. I thought you fell asleep.
Nope. I just was looking outside. I think I have another mold that needs to be removed.
Another?
Yeah.
So this has happened before?
Oh, yeah. You're not going to get very far pushing around Venom, because I've been in there with both these men, and Venom's got the strength advantage, in my honest opinion, and the brutality. Yeah, GA's a pretty tough guy, but you get Venom on the left. He may be a nice guy, but he'll rough you up.
Especially the Junk Squad, who deserve it.
He may be a wrestler, but not much of a wrestler. I'm out of it. Woo. And Venom, true reverse, back body drop. Uh-oh. Average! stepping in the ring. Yeah, I said it.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah, this is going to work. There you go.
God damn it.
Comes off the ring, taking down both members of the Junk Squad. People want better. And the other tag member of 101 Proof is in the ring right now. Uh-oh, he's going up top. He's running up high in the air there. It's a well-known fact that Bret Bryan's head was so high that when he played football in high school, he didn't even need to wear a helmet.
It's amazing.
The things I know, right?
Things you know. I'm sure you saw every game, too.
Just homecoming. Largest dry crowd in Apollo history.
Apollo.
Yeah.
Is that a theater?
Yeah, Apollo High School Theater, whatever, you know.
Same thing.
It's like McDonald's. You know, there's McDonald's restaurant.
McDonald's?
Yeah. There's McDonald's restaurant.
Then there's McDonald's farm.
Oh, yeah, nice. Well, let me put this way. I hope that the Junk Squad is 0-2 tonight with me beating Kleck Michaels already tonight. I hope the Junk Squad is going to lose their tag belts because they cheat. And Pete Huge going into no man's land.
Well, the cheaters.
Yeah, they never crossed it. And they get their wives ticked off at them. Can't cheat and run. That's how it works.
Only Eddie could.
Only Eddie?
Cheat to win.
Oh, but he didn't cheat on his wife.
True.
Don't. God rest his soul. Don't bash his name. Eddie Guerrero is a tremendous individual.
Indeed.
Bray Bryan fighting out of the corner. Here comes Pete. Blocks. GA to the floor, or to the apron. Oh! And I'll tell you right now, that a rope into the dick will not help your back. Oh, near fall. Near fall. The hanging DDT is more deadly than the regular DDT, which was invented.
You would know.
I would. I've taken both, unfortunately. Back tag. Oh no! I'm gonna let you know right now that I've probably taken more junk sandwiches than anybody else and they hurt. Actually, did you know that someone was gonna sponsor the Junk Squad and have their own junk sandwich?
Wow.
All it was a piece of bread with crap on it because they suck. Pretty good, huh? There we go.
That was amazing.
Yeah. I think the Junk Squad's terrible.
We're freaking Everclear on.
Despite what Chris V says, who's not here tonight. So it just goes to show you.
No support for his
No support from Chris V. His favorite tag team, yes. And you know what? He's not even here tonight, so it proves that they can't even draw Chris V. Chris V goes to like every show ever made, or else it doesn't exist. But these fans.
The show is not happening.
No, the show does not happen. That's why I feel free to do commentary, say whatever I want. This is uncensored commentary.
Completely uncensored.
There we go. Getting into this.
Tells him.
Rod Page with some profanity as well.
It's all around.
That would make a nun blush.
Hopefully there are no nuns here.
I don't think so. Nuns generally don't go to wrestling. Generally sinners go to wrestling.
Sinners.
Yeah.
All of us.
Hey, you pay attention.
Uh-oh. That's not a smart idea to ride. It is a 2-on-1 gang style beating at the hands of these individuals. Everyone's just saying like the D word.
D
The D word. I would not say this on commentary. That goes against my morals. Kick to the damn back.
Come on. Come on, Sandy.
He's dragged to the center of the ring. One, two, and he kicks out at two. It was a damn close three count, though.
Damn it.
Yeah. Damn it is right.
I mean, it's good.
Yeah.
Because we don't want the junk squad being victorious.
That is true.
The tables will turn tonight, my friend.
I have a feeling it's 101 proofs night. Shoot out the rope. Back elbow.
We are in a bar, so.
Yeah, anything can happen in a bar. Or in an event center. What happens in Amery stays in Amery.
Thank goodness.
Yeah. Just crushing the jaw of Bret O'Brien. And if he crushes it too much, he won't be able to drink a lot of beer tonight. Which is what Amery is for people to get drunk and do crazy things. And the loud Bret O'Brien chant erupts in the former North Star Event Center, which is now the TAC.
The capacity event center.
Actually, it's fuller than you think. There's also a second level to this. We open up the sky roof. And we have millions watching in 37 different countries on closed-circuit television. A lot of fans don't like to sit in seats anymore. They like to just, watch from the ceiling.
We are sitting next to our Spanish commentators.
Well, let's not get carried away. There's not a lot of Spanish people in Wisconsin.
But all around the world.
What?
You said they can hear us all around the world.
Yeah, but Wisconsin is not approved by at least 37 countries.
I don't blame them.
I think you're forgetting about the Bosnia-Wisconsin War of 1914. But in my defense, I fought valiantly.
Yes, you did.
This guy's hand on the rope. You cannot continue to count with your hand on the rope. That is... I'm getting distracted here on commentary.
We're being saved by our dear friend.
The Anarchist joining us on commentary.
I'm back.
Did you ask me? I did. I did commentary for your match, Eric Cannon.
I won my match.
So did I.
That's why you
I won it for you. You're welcome.
Who do you want to win this match?
Anybody but the junk squad, I'll take.
There we go.
You're sitting at the right table.
Oh, Bret turned it back.
Venom again.
Venom's unbelievable. Venom rats in.
Rob Page using his brute strength.
It's the suspenders. They give him strength.
Power up the elastic. Snapmare by the genuine article.
And they are just working over Bret O'Brien. Picking apart the body, the extremities.
Both inner and outer.
Inner and outer.
That's an interesting call. The inner and outer extremities.
And the typical baseball rally is breaking out into this Amery crowd.
Like, oh.
The Atlanta Braves.
Well, baseball chant, right?
Yeah, but the... whatever. What? Here comes the tag of Venom! Here comes Venom! Back out of the house! Rap! Kicked to the gut by Venom!
It's okay, we
he's got
now.
Fight for Venom! Oh!
I wonder what that hurts worse, the midsection or the genitalia.
Whichever one.
Big leaping save by Pete.
I hope he didn't eat anything before that. Because he is right close.
Let me tell you something. I hate to admit this, but I've seen Pete Huge in the back. And it ain't that big.
Thank you, Eric Cannon, for your insight.
Oh! Jumping knees on Pete Huge!
The capacity crowd here at the attack. The reputation of Venom and Poof. This miscommunication shoots him in. Here comes Venom.
I'm a little low on voice.
Yeah.
A little low too?
Yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah, I'm a little low.
Pete Huge.
Pete Huge.
huge trying to pick back the pieces after getting this miscommunication, jumping knees in the corner, shades of Horus the psychopath.
A hell of a fall. That's got to be a two-legged
hey! Unbelievable.
Oh, they're going to take the pin pretty huge. How many shots to the neck can one man take? Brother Brian's going up top. Watch out for the ceiling fan. I'm surprised Pete Huge isn't dead.
Uh-oh. Shades of Marco Styles Cordova.
Oh! Oh, and
not up there. That's bad for the genitals.
Oh.
Thank you.
Oh, next snap. What's this going to be? He's back up the outside.
He's up top.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no. That's a Ken Kennedy. No. Second rock. That's got to be it. Huge. Jenny Rock with cover. 1, 2, and 3.
I'm pissed.
Son of a bitch.
I'm pissed.
I'm boycotting. The winners. And still. Tag team champions, some sons of bitches.
Unbelievable.
The junk sweater, a bunch of fricks. They just showed it. I don't care how many bucks you have, but if you got a chip to win, you don't know how to win a match. That's illegal.
Wouldn't cheating be a way to win?
It's not a glorious way to win. And you know what happens to cheaters?
They never prosper.
Exactly, right? Angela? But, yeah.
But, they do go home with the belts.
Yeah, well, they're just replicas anyway. Oh, I think that about empties the guns here tonight at straight shooting with their cannon and Derek.
Forget our dear friend Angela,
who promised that she would join us again on commentary.
Fantastic. Hopefully she'll join us at the after party in room 303.
Yes, at the Ramada Motel.
Yeah.
Not that Bates Motel down the street.
The
Gunners and the Jump Squad are still your nobody impact right now.
For those of you in attendance, thanks for coming. For those of you at home, thanks for purchasing the DVD.
Sorry for all those who I offended, which would be every minority in the room.
NIWWrestling.com, over and out.
And I wouldn't want to be a...
Alrighty. Pimps up, hose down.
Since you've been gone.